Hello friends, welcome to our channel, and today we're going to start with an update regarding Blue Origin's first successful fairing prototype test of their upcoming New Glenn rocket. On the 1st of February, Blue Origin announced that they've accomplished an important test of the payload fairing of their forthcoming New Glenn rocket at NASA's Armstrong Test Facility in Ohio, which also houses the largest vacuum chamber of the world. Shauna Sherwood Ryan, project manager and test coordinator for Blue Origin, said, "This is the only place in the world that we can test out this fairing in an environment similar to what the rocket will be seeing in space." In a video published by Blue Origin on their official Twitter page, they said that this fairing prototype test was the first successful integrated New Glenn hardware test. Park Cover, senior director of New Glenn Stage 2 and payload accommodations, commented that, "This is a very exciting day." As we know, New Glenn is going to be the first orbital launch vehicle from Blue Origin. The rocket has the capability of sending 45 metric tons to low Earth orbit and around 14 tons to geostationary transfer orbit. New Glenn has a height of almost 96 meters. Blue Origin plans to launch their New Glenn rockets from the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, Launch Complex 36, in the future. If we compare Blue Origin's rocket with the SpaceX Falcon rockets, then we can see that Glenn has similarity with Falcon Heavy in terms of carrying capacity. New Glenn has an upper hand in terms of design, which is what Falcon Heavy does with one core and two side boosters. Glenn is designed to perform the same thing with a single booster, making it much more similar to single-core Falcon 9. The New Glenn rocket system also comprises a fully reusable booster, an expendable upper stage, just as SpaceX rocket features. Glenn has another striking feature of having the largest composite payload fairing in the world at present, which can be further expanded according to mission requirements. New Glenn will launch barely a mile south of the land-based landing zones some Falcon boosters land at. But SpaceX had already proven the reusability features of their rockets. They've also reused their payload fairings, and moreover, they've reflown the boosters numerous times in a very fast launch cadence. On the other hand, New Glenn is totally under development phase, and it may take years for them to come for launch. So in matters of experience, SpaceX is years ahead of Blue Origin. As per sources state, the main agenda of Blue Origin's test was to test the separation and jettison procedure of fairing halves and then ensure accurate exposure of the payload to the space for deployment. The company said, "This test validated acoustics, cleanliness, and environments that payload customers are expecting. Keeping the jettisoned fairing halves far away from the rocket was needed to avoid any disaster due to recontact with the fairing halves. Thus, this was also taken into notice during fairing prototype tests." According to reports, the Blue Origin fairings is perhaps the simplest large assembly of any orbital launch vehicle. Till now, Blue Origin didn't reveal their progress with the New Glenn booster or second stage. This recent payload fairing test raises hopes for an orbital launch attempt late this year or early next year. Now let's move to an update regarding spy satellites SpaceX is dealing with these days. SpaceX launched another Falcon 9 rocket from California on Wednesday, 2 days after launching an Italian remote sensing satellite from Florida. This one was carrying a classified National Reconnaissance Office spy satellite. The rapid-fire launch paced 6 orbit-class missions in 28 days, follows a record 31 Falcon 9 flights in 2021, with more than 50 expected this year, a cadence made possible by recovering, refurbishing, and relaunching the rocket's first or core stages. The Falcon 9 used a fresh new booster for Wednesday's flight, which flew back to a picture-perfect landing on Landing Zone 4 near SpaceX's Vandenberg Space Force Base launch pad. The NRO intends to fly the booster again, as per a renowned U.S. intelligence organization. Their most up-to-date spy satellite successfully launched into orbit on a reusable SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. According to the National Reconnaissance Office, NRO, which is responsible for the U.S. Space Force, the SpaceX rocket took off at 12:27 p.m. local time from the Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. They've also mentioned that the Falcon 9 rocket landed back at the base after releasing the satellite NROL-87 into orbit without any issues. Little is known about NROL-7. This is a classified payload, like most satellites operated by the NRO. NRO officials typically ask launch providers to limit launch live feeds to short launch times of a few minutes. NROL-87 is planned, constructed, and worked by the NRO to help its upward surveillance mission. As per the organization's insight regarding the satellite, it will give a wide scope of convenient intelligence data. Now let's take a quick glance at SpaceX's third Falcon 9 rocket launch in just 67 hours. Just like the previous two Falcon 9 launches, Starlink 4-7 launch was dangling on delays. It faced a delay from the 29th of January until the 2nd of February, and finally SpaceX successfully launched the Starlink mission on the 3rd of February at 1:13 p.m. Eastern Time. This successful launch made SpaceX achieve a launch cadence of three Falcon 9 launches in just 67 hours, taking the earlier two launches into account were CSG-2 and NROL missions. It also marks the sixth launch of SpaceX in 2022, and that too in less than 5 weeks. This mission delivered the seventh batch of Starlink V1.5 satellites to LEO, which counts up to 49. With this addition of Starlink satellites, SpaceX achieved the mark of deploying 2,000 Starlink satellites into orbit, creating a record. The V1.5 Starlink satellites with laser interlink weigh approximately 290 kilograms, which is 30 to 40 kilograms heavier than the Starlink V1 satellites. In this mission, SpaceX used a booster, B-1061, for this mission. It marked the sixth launch of its own, along with a successful landing on a drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas, nearly 9 minutes after launch. SpaceX also broke the payload fairing reusability record in this mission. One of the fairing halves has completed its fourth launch, but the other half has successfully completed its sixth launch, breaking the earlier fairing reusability record. The six-time flown payload fairing was last used in May 2021. Sources state that SpaceX had earlier flown and recovered another fairing for the fifth time in January 2022. In the context of booster reuse, earlier SpaceX had taken almost 2 years and 8 months after first reuse for reusing it for the fourth time, but to complete the fifth and sixth time reuse, SpaceX took only 9 months. But the pace of reusing fairings is much faster, indicating the increasing proficiency of SpaceX in reusability. As we're discussing Starlink, let's also discuss their latest premium plan. With over 1,900 satellites in orbit, SpaceX is now taking the next step with a brand new premium tier that guarantees better download and upload speeds and consists of a bigger antenna that will effectively serve in severe climate conditions. The new tier won't come cheap, however, it is bendy and could provide 24/7 prioritized aid for customers. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk shared the information on Twitter on Wednesday, calling Starlink Premium. The brand new device has a larger, higher antenna with a larger surface area and a broader scan angle. Ideally, this indicates the device gives greater bandwidth, a 159 to 500 megabits per second download speed, and a latency of 20 to 40 milliseconds, and must deliver good enough in adverse climate conditions. SpaceX says the premium tier is good for small offices, storefronts, and exceptional customers throughout the globe. SpaceX has continued their earlier plan so that the brand new carrier does not include a long time period agreement or a data cap. The fee has gone up notably in comparison to the $499 basic Starlink pack, however. The Starlink premium package includes the antenna, Wi-Fi router, and tripod, and costs around $2,500. For comparison, the usual bundle gives download speeds between 100 and 200 megabits per second, though minimal latency is the same at 20 milliseconds. Additionally, while the monthly fee for the standard Starlink kit is $99 per month, the fee for the premium package is $500 per month. Finally, the pre-order deposit is also pricier at $500, compared to $100 for the standard Starlink kit. Starlink emerged out of beta in October 2021, but the company has a pretty big backlog of unfulfilled orders. The new, pricier system probably won't see that much demand, but it'll still be a wait before you can get one. You can order Starlink Premium now, but SpaceX says the first orders will be fulfilled mid-2022.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.